Hello, everybody. Today I'm going to be going over my spring must-haves. I have some from drugstore, some from high-end. So I gave you an alternative of both. Mainly focusing on long-wearing, colorful, not too heavy on the skin, all that good stuff. So let's just go ahead and jump right in. So first thing we're going to go ahead and start off with is blush. So a blush that I have fallen in love with for a couple of years now. I use it quite often. It is from NYX and it's called Cinnamon. So this is Cinnamon right here. It's an orangish type of color. It is a matte. The longevity of this blush is just amazing. And I mean, look at that color. You might look at an orange and be like, there is no way that I'm able to pull that off. I believe that anybody can pull off pretty much any color. You can tone it down, put some powder over it. You can just use like a duo fiber brush and apply it very lightly on your skin. I feel that this would be amazing on so many different complexions. One from a high end is this one from MAC, and it is Peaches. I'm pretty sure you guys have heard it before. This is just an amazing, amazing peach corally color. It is so smooth, sheer tone blush, not completely matte. It is a little bit lighter than the Cinnamon from NYX, as you can see. So this is probably a little bit more wearable on a lot of more skin tones and a little bit more on the safe side for those of you that are kind of scared to use an orange blush. You'd probably want to go with this because it does have like a type of baby pink undertones. For the lips from NYX, I love all NYX lip products, but the butter lipsticks are just amazing. If you guys haven't swatched them or used them before, these last on your lips forever. And it looks a little bit sheer on camera, but I promise you, once you apply it on your lips, it does not look sheer whatsoever. That color that I just showed you right now is Fizzies. And then their butter glosses are just amazing. I just grabbed a random one. I have quite a bit. This one is in Merengue. And then it's like a baby pink with like, I'd say like a blue undertone. It is amazing. I love all of the butter lip glosses, but this one is probably one of my favorite ones. Lipsticks, I picked too high end, not because of, I mean, MAC does last forever on your lips, but because of these colors. You guys definitely need these two colors in your life. They are just amazing. I definitely gravitate to them for spring and summer because or all year round, but more around here. Candy Yum Yum. Oh my gosh, it is just an amazing color. This is a matte shade. And I mean, seriously, it is amazing. You can't, like, I've tried finding dupes because I was gonna do a dupe video. No, there are no dupes for Candy Yum Yum. I'm sorry. You can say that there is, but there is not. This one is Lady Danger. It looks orange on camera, but I promise you, it's like an orangish red. It looks amazing on the skin. I'm a NC35. It looks great on my complexion. So if you guys are similar to my skin tone, it'll look amazing on you with like a neutral eye. I mean, come on. Just please try it out. Please, please, please just listen to me when I tell you that you need these colors in your life. I am not lying to you. Like, no. You need these colors in your life. I convinced my best friend to get it, both of these, because she was just like, oh, I don't know. But seriously, they are amazing. They look beautiful on her. She's lighter than I am. So they're amazing, guys. Just go swatch them, feel them on your lips. Like, I can't even say enough good things about them. They're beautiful. Eyebrows. Eyebrows is a huge thing to me. I always have to have my eyebrows on, and if I don't, I wear some big old sunglasses so that you do not see my eyebrows. But I don't have any drugstore products for your eyebrows. I have a few, but I'm not going to go over them with you because they're not as good as these. For springtime, you want something that is going to last on your eyebrows forever, as in the sweating. If you're out, you want waterproof eyebrows. You want your eyebrows to look the same way you did when you walked out that door, whether you went to go run a marathon or you swam across the Pacific Ocean. You want your eyebrows to stay on your face, okay? So, what I use First of all, I use a lot of high-end stuff. So this is the Tarte Mousse. My color is in medium brown. I have it on today, and this is a waterproof mousse, so it is just amazing on your brows. I love it. It's such a natural finish. Now, if I'm going out or if I have heavy eye makeup on and I feel like my eyebrows don't need to be calmed down as much as they are now, even though they might not look calmed down, this is calmed down because I don't have too much going on my face. If I want something a little bit more, if you guys are going out, anything, whatever, you guys are going to be out all night, definitely check out this Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade. I have two colors. I use chocolate for the inner corner, and then I fade it in into dark brown. Because if you guys have had problems with this, now, I even had the problem with the brow wiz. So if you guys have this problem with the brow wiz, you're going to love these two products, whichever one that you guys want to get. But I have a problem with the corners of my eyebrows fading out after a while. No, this does not fade out whatsoever. I promise you, when you're washing your face and you're taking off your makeup, you have to sit there and scrub your eyebrows, how good this stays on your eyebrows. I don't use a lot of product. You don't have to use a lot of product for this. So definitely go to Sephora or Ulta. Go see what shade that you are at. You definitely need this for spring, summer. I know you guys are going to be swimming, getting wet, running, sweating, all that nasty stuff. Like, you need these in your life if you are a big eyebrow person and you don't have these already. The Brow Wiz does not compare to these two. I used the Brow Wiz forever, and towards the end of the day, my eyebrows were faded around here, and I don't want half of my eyebrow. Like, I seriously look like that for the remainder of the day, and people were probably like, oh, poor girl, she needs help. No, I didn't need help. I just needed a better product. So these are amazing. I love these. Another thing, I'm gonna be honest with you. I went a little pluck happy on my eyebrows, so they're a lot thinner now, and they look different. Oh my gosh, they look different. My eyebrows look different. I'll fix those later. Don't even worry about it. Just don't look at this eyebrow. This eyebrow is good. You guys can go ahead and look at that one, but don't look at this one anymore for the rest of the video. But anyway, the Gimme Brow. This is the color in, I believe, dark brown or medium brown. Yeah, medium deep is the color. And it looks like this. And it's specifically made to just enhance the hairs on your brows. It's not intended to sculpt your brows or to add more hairs, like fill in your eyebrows. It's not intended for that. So if you have like no hair on your brows and you just want to put this on and fill it and look like you just did dry brows, no, that's not the case. If you have naturally thicker eyebrows, or your eyebrows are fuller at the time, you can just pop this on, just shape in your eyebrows the way you would like an eyebrow gel, and this will stay on your brows all day. I don't believe it claims to be waterproof. I don't think it is waterproof, but it's just something for quick on-the-go BB cream, a gimme brow, you're good to go with some mascara. So this is an awesome product for you guys to check out. Not a necessity, but I mean, if you guys are the type of person where you just want to get up and go, this will be definitely a thing, because with the pomades and the mousse, you do have to spend a little bit more time on your brows than you would with the gimme brow. For primers, I have two. I have one from the drugstore, the Rimmel Stay Matte Primer. It's really, really bright. You can't really see that, but it's just amazing. It kind of looks like a moisturizer lotion. It feels like a primer, but the consistency of it is a white, you know, form, and it just looks like a lotion. You just put it on. It does feel like tacky, kind of the way MAC Pro Longwear feels, so you know that it's going to stay in your skin and soak up all that foundation so that nothing leaves your face. I love the feeling of that. It just makes me feel more secure that my makeup's going to stay on. For high end, I use the Too Faced Primed and Poreless Primer, which I have fallen in love with recently. That's all I've been using, and I just love it. The consistency on this is like a, you know, skin tone color. It's not a white color. This one feels a lot different than the matte primer does, because this one doesn't claim to keep you matte. This one is specifically to keep you matte. So if you are a really oily person, which I know during the summer, you sweating and everything, a lot of people do get really, really oily. So I'd probably suggest this one. This one is just to keep your makeup on, and I feel like it keeps my makeup on all day until I'm ready to take it off myself. Last two products are concealers, which I believe is something that's very, very, very important, not only during the springtime or summertime, but all years around. Especially me, I have really dark circles. So I have one from the high end, which you guys are already gonna know what I'm gonna say. It's the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer. This one is more to highlight than to conceal my dark circles. This one is in NC25, and then for NW is for dark circles. And C is more of like a yellow tone base, so it's more to highlight your face. So if you guys were confused about the NW and NC, that's the difference between these. So my NW broke, so this is my NC25, which I use to highlight. I love it. It is just amazing. As you know, it does not crease, stays on your under eyes or wherever you want to conceal all day long. Just be very careful because I seriously have almost dropped this a couple of times, and I cannot afford to be dropping this like if it's like $2. So be very careful because it is glass and it does break very easily. All I did was from my vanity, which isn't tall at all, it just fell on the floor and broke and went everywhere. So it was I wanted to cry. Another alternative, which I feel like doesn't crease on my eyes, and I have a lot of fine lines. It doesn't crease, it conceals perfectly, it highlights the part that I want to highlight. This is a NYX HD Concealer. Now, there are, I believe, three or four shades. The shade that I got is in medium, which I always go for medium, but as you can tell, it's a very light medium. So it does highlight my face perfectly. There is one shade below this, and it's light, but it's very, very light. So if you're lighter than me, that'll probably be your best bet, was to get the light one. If not, if you're about NC35 or a little bit higher, like one shade higher, you can probably get off with going with the medium. Anything lower than me, I would suggest a light concealer from the NYX HD. And NYX are always like buy one, get one 50% off, also, so it's even better. Like, stock up then. Foundation. I don't have a drugstore foundation that I feel is a lightweight coverage and doesn't feel like I have anything on my skin whatsoever. So I would definitely have to go with the Naked Skin. If you guys have not tried this, it is just amazing. I use it with like a dual fiber brush, and you could spray some Studio Fix just to set it in a little bit more into your skin and everything like that. I feel like it gives it a little bit more of a natural look. I really, really love this Naked Skin. My color is in 7.0. There are like a million and one shades of this foundation. You could always get color matched at Sephora. They can even give you a little sample in the jar so that you can try it out a little bit. That's what I did, and that sample actually lasted me a while. So if you guys want to check that out, I feel like this is a perfect spring summer must have if you don't want to feel like you have a lot of makeup on, but you want that coverage. I actually have it on today. I feel like I have a lot of coverage going on, and you can build this up if you want. You know, this is just one coat. If you want to add a little bit more, you can definitely do that with this foundation. It is very buildable if you wanted it to be. So yeah, so definitely that's all that I have. I'm pretty sure that I can keep talking about what you need, what you don't need, and all that stuff, but I just wanted to mainly focus on spring products, the longevity of them, the way they cover up, the feel of them, and everything like that, just to feel fresh and, you know, get your spring on and everything like that. So, thank you guys for watching once again. I want to thank all of my new subscribers that I haven't thanked for joining me on my channel. Just amazing to feel all of the love, all of the comments, messaging. Once again, thank you guys so much for being here with me. I love you all, and I will talk to you guys next week. Thank you. Bye.